I decided to go to the zoo to steal a monkey, but of course, just a monkey is useless. I also had to get a typewriter, so on my way back, I took a typewriter from the gift shop. After I got rid of the cops, I put the monkey behind the machine and gave him a banana. He started typing, fast. I immediately knew he was onto something. When the little man was finally finished, I snatched the paper and it read, blah, blah, blah. Of course, what else was supposed to happen? Well, anything could have happened. The monkey could have written wake up, or the cure for cancer, or the full script to the legend of Tarzan, Lord of the Apes. If I gave the guy a chance and enough time, he could almost surely write anything and everything in existence. The words almost surely mean that the event has a probability of 1, which means that it is certain to happen eventually. However, this doesn't mean that it'll happen soon or in a finite amount of time. But somewhere on the infinite timeline, there will come a time where the monkey writes the code for GTA 6. Before I tell you why exactly this is important, let's quickly get a sense of the scale here. Let's say we wanted Robert to type the word banana. Suppose the typewriter has 50 keys and that he types 1 letter per second on average. The chance that the first letter typed is a B is 1 in 50. The chance that the second letter typed is an A is also 1 in 50. So the chance that Robert types banana is 1 in 15,625,000,000, which means that on average it would take him 343 years. That's a long time, but still doable. But this can quickly get out of hand. If you wanted him to type the script to Hamlet, we would have to wait for 2.76 times 10 to the 220,858 years, which is just a hilariously big number. So big that I had to use a special big number calculator just to do the calculations. This is commonly called the Infinite Monkey Theorem, because the more popular version uses an infinite amount of monkeys, but if you give just one monkey an infinite amount of time, he will accomplish the exact same result. If you're still wondering why this is important, I'll tell you right now. It shows us that, theoretically speaking, with an infinite universe, there are infinite possibilities. So in an infinite universe, there are infinite versions of you, and infinite slightly different versions of you, meaning that there is a you that dies right here, right now, and there is a you that lives forever, and there is a you that is watching this video right now while jumping off the Eiffel Tower. But it gets much crazier. This also implies that there could be a brain floating somewhere in space that just happens to have the exact same configuration as your brain. This is called a Boltzmann brain. And for all we know, this could be you. That's not as crazy as it might seem. The Boltzmann brain argument suggests that it is more likely for a brain to form in a void than it is for the entire universe containing your brain to form in a void. In some theorems, normal human brains are actually less likely than Boltzmann brains. So, statistically speaking, you are most likely a chunk of brain matter floating through space, imagining that you're watching this video with fake memories of your family, house, pets, ambitions, friends, goals, everything. But just like any other scientific theory, this was all just made up by humans. No one really knows what's going on. This just makes it clear that anything is possible. Oh, I think the cops are here. I have to finish this quickly. I still wanted to talk about time travel, but I guess my time is up, so quickly click this video if you don't mind.